Since I've been a little kid, I've loved animals. And oddly enough, I never really thought about it until I got where I was today looking back. I always really liked rodents. A lot of the research that's done in my lab has to do with animal welfare and trying to figure out how to provide for the needs of captive animals. We got into rat tickling in order to improve the welfare of laboratory rats.
And the reason that it's called tickling is because the motion that you do with your fingers is very similar to a human.
There are two main aspects that we're trying to mimic of rat rough and tumble play. And the first one is the dorsal contact, which you use your fingers to lightly touch the back of the rat's neck. And then the second aspect is the pin, where one rat will jump on top of the other rat and pin it to the ground. And they kind of go back and forth with this. And so we try to mimic with our hand these two aspects.
We often get comments that, well, I really don't like tickling, or, you know, I've always hated being tickled. But let me assure you that rat tickling is not the same as human tickling. It's much more like wrestling with your dog or a small child that's laughing. It's not very similar at all, really, to tickling an adult human.
So when rats are tickled, they give off these ultrasonic vocalizations, which we as humans can't actually hear. And so we use a bat detector in order to bring that down to a level that's audible to us as humans in order to hear these positive vocalizations. They do these vocalizations when they're playing, when they eat really tasty treats. And so it's really exciting for us to have this indicator of positive welfare for rats.
We often get the question of, can I tickle other laboratory species? The short answer is no. Please don't tickle your mice. They will probably bite you because they don't play the same as rats.
By increasing this human-animal interaction, the animals are more likely to want to interact with us. So we're reducing fear, we're reducing stress. And when it comes to utilizing these animals in a scientific aspect, it's probably going to make them better models for the research that any scientist is going to be doing. We want to give them the highest quality of life possible. And this is one way to actually give them a positive interaction, positive experience when working with humans that is very unique. And it's a really exciting way to interact with the animals and do it in such a positive, fun way.